In today's video, I'm going to show you one simple little setting that will take your poo engravings from frown town to brown town. Let's go. Hey everyone, my name is Sam and welcome back to Samcraft. That's right, in today's video, we're going to be talking about poo emoji coasters, but that's not exactly the subject of today. It's just a wonderful example of a bad result and a good one. In today's video, it's going to be a quick, brief, hopefully save your sanity video to let you know about one little setting in Lightburn that really makes the difference between a bad or good engraving. The problem that I've been having that I want to show you how I fixed is fading or poor quality engraving, specifically with my slate coasters on my xTool engraver. This is not an issue specific to slate, but slate, just being what it is, shows this up more predominantly than materials such as wood or other objects. So the best thing to show you exactly what's happening is to look at the videos here. I have a coaster here that I did just plain text and said, "Why is it fading away?" As you can see, there are faded edges. The very outside perimeter, if you look at it, it's not a crisp, definitive line between engraving and not. It kind of feathers or kind of blends away. In addition to that, you can see horizontal lines that run between the text and inside the middle of the engravings. It's the kind of effect that if it was a computer printer, you would think, I must be running low on ink. That doesn't really happen with lasers, but it is the same kind of outcome. This issue does not only happen with text, but also with engraving solid objects. This next example here, I have four squares that I drew in Lightburn, exactly 1 inch by 1 inch, and I did text that says no overscan. There you go. Hint, spoiler alert, overscanning is what we're going to be talking about today. In this example, you can see that I have the feathering or the fading both in the text and the actual boxes themselves. You have a little bit of what looks like shifting of the laser. Something weird is going on, and it really makes you wonder what the problem is. So there are the bad examples. Let me go ahead and show you some of the good ones and talk about why overscanning fixed it for me. At least I think so. First up is the text, the mirror image of why is it fading away. Here's your answer. xTool needs overscan. You can see a definitive clear edge all the way around the border of the text, and there is no printer is almost out of ink feel to the engraving throughout the middle. This is a clear, crisp engraving. This looks great. Looking at the squares again, you can see that I have four definitive squares. They are exactly 1 inch by 1 inch, nice crisp edges, good corners, and the text on this coaster is also nice and crisp. Very, very good. So at this point, you're probably wondering, wow, Sam, how did you ever figure this out? Are you just a child genius? Well, I'm not a genius, and I've been called a child, so I don't know how to answer that one. But I came across this one day as I was watching the xTool run some coasters for another test I did, the vertical defocusing test. It's the video before this one. If you haven't seen that one, check it out below. I noticed on some of those jobs, the xTool would jolt and jar, almost as if the stepper motors were skipping a step, there was skipping a tooth, or something weird was going on. As I spent more time kind of watching the job, I realized that laser head, when it reached the end of what it wanted to engrave, was immediately slamming it in reverse and going the opposite direction. I thought to myself, that's probably not too good for that machine to do. I remember there's a setting in Lightburn that helps ramp up and down. Let's go find it. Jumping into Lightburn, I saw the setting for overscan and set it to the default value. Rerunning that job, I didn't have any problems with that jarring or that clunking noise, and it did a lot better. As I did more tests, I noticed a really, really good improvement. While I didn't cover it in that video because that was just the one subject for that one video, I witnessed it and I knew that I wanted to make this video for you guys. Whether or not this issue persists in xTool creative space or if it is only applicable to Lightburn, I honestly don't know. I don't use xTool creative space. I only use Lightburn. And that's the only thing I honestly recommend anyone else do. If your laser is compatible with Lightburn, use it. If you are looking at a laser and you want to know, should I get it, should I not? Unless there are major differences, if there is Lightburn compatible versus non-compatible, get the Lightburn compatible. There's a reason this software is the industry standard for diode, galvo, infrared, and CO2 lasers. So this obviously brings up the question, overscanning. Okay, it's a checkbox in Lightburn, but what exactly does it do? For this answer, we're going to jump right from Lightburn into their help section, search for overscanning, and we can find our answer super quick. Overscanning, when enabled, adds extra moves to the beginning and end of each line to give the laser time to speed up before firing and slow down afterward. If your machine has low acceleration or you see darker burns at the sides of your fills, you may need to increase the amount of overscanning. If you do not see this setting, your machine is likely a DSP controller and handles this automatically in the hardware. There you go. So by just clicking this button, we're making the xTool spend more time on a line before it moves on. It's not cutting itself right off right where the image or engraving stops to move ahead. It's kind of slowing down and speeding up. Pretty amazing. This one little checkbox makes so much of a difference. To round things out here, we started off with a sad poop emoji. This little guy's sad. He feels a little bit fading away. Parts of him might be blending off into the distance. Not anymore. This guy is happy. He is crisp. We can definitely see that poo line, and we know exactly where it is and is not. This is one happy little piece of poo. So there you go, guys. One simple little setting in Lightburn. Perhaps this has been driving you crazy. Perhaps you are about to give up on the world of laser engraving. Don't quit just yet. Check it out. See if this setting change makes your engravings that much better. If you got any questions or comments, you guys know what to do. Leave them for me down below. Love to answer them and read all of them. Otherwise, take care, and I'll see you guys next time in the workshop. Me and Mr. Happy Poo will be hanging out here. Of course, now that sign says on air poop. Poop on air. Is that saying something about the quality of this content?